and this is how you are going to represent your multiplexer. Here in multiplexer, you are going to represent with a rectangular box, and you are going to have the inputs, and you are going to have the selection lines, and you are going to have your final output, that is your single output. The inputs are going to be from D0 to D2 power n minus 1. Why I'm taking here 2 power n minus 1 means I'm starting my inputs from D0. So you are going to have 2 power n inputs. So I'm going to represent from 0 so that I'm going to have D2 power n minus 1. And I'm going to have n number of selection lines, that is from S1 to S power n, and I'm going to have only a single output, that is your final output. And here 2 power n by 1 represents, thus multiplexer is going to be called as 2 power n by 1 mux. Why? Because you are going to apply 2 power n inputs and you are going to have your one output. It represents here 2 power n represents your number of inputs, and 1 represents your output, number of outputs. And next we'll see what are the applications of your multiplexer, where you are going to use this multiplexers, and what is the use of your multiplexer. Multiplexers can be used where you can transmit multiple data. While you are going to transmit multiple data to a single destination or different destinations, you can transmit more number of or multiple or different data using a single line. You can combine all these input signals and the final output is going to be a single output. You can transmit this output to different destinations or same destination. And one of the important application is in your communication systems. In communication systems, by using your multiplexer, you can increase the efficiency of communication system by allowing the transmission of data such as audio and video from different channels through a single line. That means you can take more number of inputs, that is you can transmit at a time audio signal and video signal. By combining these two signals through a single line, you can transmit your data. And next one is your telephone networks. In telephone networks, it integrate the multiple audio signals on a single line of transmission. Here also you can transmit multiple audio signals through a single transmission line. By using your multiplexer, these two are important applications. And the advantages of this multiplexer is, by using your multiplexer, we are saying that you can transmit multiple data through a single line. That means the main advantage is you can reduce the number of components you are going to use, or you can say you can reduce the number of wire connections. And by reducing your connections or your number of devices which are connected, you can reduce the complexity of your circuit, and your cost of your circuit can also be reduced. This is the main advantage of your multiplexer. By using your multiplexer, you can reduce the complexity of your circuit and the cost of designing your circuit, and the number of devices you are going to use can also be reduced. Why? Because by using a single multiplexer, you can transmit more number of input data. These are the applications and advantages of your multiplexer. And next we'll see there are different types of multiplexers depending on number of inputs. We are going to have 2 by 1 mux, 4 by 1 mux, 16 by 1 mux, and 32 by 1 mux. Here 2 by 1 mux means here 2 represents your input and 1 represents your output. So here 2 in 2 by 1 mux, you are going to have 2 inputs and 1 output, And here your selection lines are going to be, you are going to state it as 2 power n inputs. That means you are going to have 2 means that is 2 power 1. So n is going to be 1. So your number of selection lines, that is n is equal to 1. And again here you are going to have 4 inputs and 1 output. Here n is going to be 2. So you are going to have 2 selection lines. That's how you are going to have your for different types of multiplexes. You are going to call it as 2 by 1 mux, 4 by 1 mux. In 2 by 1 mux, you are going to have 2 inputs, 1 output and 1 selection lines. In detail, we'll see how you are going to design a 2 by 1 mux. As I have said that 2 by 1 mux is going to have 2 inputs, 1 selection line and 1 output. The block diagram is going to be like this. You are going to represent with a rectangular box. As we are saying that 2 by 1 mux, you are going to have 2 inputs. I am going to take them as D0, D1. And you are going to have only 1 selection line. So I am stating it as S0. And you are going to have only 1 output, that is Y. Okay. And for every combinational circuit or any circuit in digital electronics, we need to write the truth table to solve the circuit. So next step you are going to have is designing or writing your truth table. So here how you are going to get your truth table, before you are going to take your truth table, first you are going to define what are the inputs and what are the outputs. You are going to have 2 inputs, that is D0, D1, and your output is Y. But your Y is going to depend on only your selection lines. So I am taking as your input as S. I am not taking your inputs as D0 or D1. Why? Because your output is selected based on your selection line. So based on this S0 only, you are going to get your desired output. So I am taking my input as S0 and my output is going to be Y. And for every mux, you are going to have a port called enable port. I'm going to represent it with E. Now I'm going to design a truth table. I'm going to have the enable port, my input, that is S0, and my output. Whenever your enable port is 0, if your enable port is 0, your circuit is going to be in off state. Whenever your enable port is at 0, your circuit will be in off state, so that your output is going to be 0 and your selection line is going to be nothing. You can whatever it is going to be select, but the final output is going to be 0 because the circuit is going to be in off condition. So this condition is called as don't care condition. You can call this condition as don't care condition. This condition will be when your enable port is at 0. If you are going to have your enable port as 1, as you are going to have your S0 only single selection line, you can have 2 possibilities, that is your S0 can be either 1 or 0. You are going to have 2 possibilities for your selection lines. Depending upon that, if your selection line is at 0, the output is going to be D0, or if your selection line is 1, your output is going to be D1. This is going to be your truth table for your 2 by 1 mux. Again, I'm explaining your truth table. Before taking your truth table, I'm going to consider my inputs and outputs. Here I'm going to consider my input as S0. Why? Because my output is going to depend on selection line. So I'm going to take my input as S naught, and I'm going to consider my output as Y, and I'm going to have one enable port. And truth table, if my enable port is at 0, that means if your enable port is at 0, the circuit will be in off condition. So you are going to have the output as 0, and this condition is called as don't care condition. And next, I'm going to have, if I'm going to take my enable port as 1 and my selection line, I'm going to have only one selection line, so I can have the possibilities, either it can be 1 or 0. So I'm taking S naught, my selection line, as 0. Whenever my selection line is 0, that is at port 0, I'm going to get my output as D naught. Whenever my S naught is, that is my selection line is 1, I'm going to get my output as D1. That's how it is going to select my output from my two inputs. This is how you are going to have your 2 by 1 marks. From this truth table, you are going to write your Boolean expression. How you are going to get your Boolean expression means, from your truth table, you are going to write your Boolean expression. From your truth table, you are going to write your Boolean expression. How you are going to write means, your output Y is equal to, what are the conditions you are having? Your S naught is 0, you are going to have D naught, and S naught is 1, you are going to have D1. So you can write it as S naught bar D naught plus S naught D1. This is my final Boolean expression from my truth table. S naught bar means it is going to be 0, S naught means 1, and this is my final output. And from this Boolean expression, I'm going to design, or I'm going to draw my logic circuit. So a logic circuit, I'm going to have the inputs S, okay, I'm taking it as S naught, and the inputs D naught and D1. The expression is going to be S naught bar D naught plus S naught D1. So I need S naught, so I'm taking my S naught input, and I'm going to give my inverter NOT gate to get my S naught bar. And next, I'm going to have S naught bar into D naught. So I'm taking S naught, and I'm taking my D naught.